we are going to discuss a new topic known as the priority queue. In case of priority queue, depending upon the queue logic and depending upon the priority number, insert, delete and arrangement of data will be decided. Now see, let us go for this example. Let us suppose we are having one priority queue and we have considered that priority 1 is higher than priority 2, higher than priority 4 and higher than priority 5. So priority 5 is lesser than priority 4. Okay. Now see, we are having all the nodes with the priority 1 will be coming earlier than all the nodes with the priority 2. All the nodes with priority 2 will be coming earlier than nodes with priority 4. All the nodes with priority 4 will be coming earlier than priority number 5 node. So this G5 will be the last node because F4 is having the priority higher than G5. So in this way, this particular linked list has been expressed. The same priority queue can be expressed also using one array, one two-dimensional array and two one-dimensional arrays. Just see, we are having A with priority 1. So this is the priority numbers. These are the priority numbers and this is the number of nodes with that priority. So with A, with priority 1, I'm having a single node A. So its start and, or rather front and rear will be at the location number 3. I've taken these 3 very arbitrarily. I could have written this one at this very particular place. Then obviously they will become 5 and 5. So I've written them very arbitrarily. Okay, now here in this case with the priority 2, I'm having 2 nodes, that is B and C. So I'm putting them B and C at location number 1 and 2. So front will be 1 and rear will be 2. So front will be 1 and rear will be 2 and they have been kept at the second row because the priority number is 2. So actually these are denoting the priority numbers. These are denoting the priority numbers. Okay, now with the priority number 3, that is no node. So that's why with the priority number 3, I didn't write anything. So front is equal to 0 and rear is equal to 0. Next, with priority 4, I'm having 3 nodes, D, E and F. So D, E and F, intentionally, I've written them in a circular way. So front will be 5 and rear will be 1. So front is 5 and rear is 1. Now, with the priority value 5, I'm having G. So at this particular priority 5, I'm putting this one at the 4th column. So that's why front is equal to 4 and rear is equal to 4. I could have written this one in other places also. Accordingly, the front and rear will get updated. So in this way, the same priority queue I have represented in linked list and I have represented the same using arrays. Now let us consider I am having one node with the priority value 2 with the info value x. Let us see what happens. So I am having one node with a priority value. So I am writing this one because that priority 2 will be inserted in between these two, prior 4 and after 1. But depending upon the queue logic, it will be inserted at the rear end. So that's why this particular node with priority value 2 and info value x, and where this particular node is going to get inserted. It will be inserted after C because C is the last node with the priority 2 and before the nodes with the priority lesser than 2. So that is 4 or 5. So now what will happen? This link will be cancelled. So it will have a link like this. And it will have a link like this. So in this way, the node will get inserted in between this particular C and D. So now we know that BCX, so X will get inserted here. So I'm requiring this X to be inserted here. So my rear will become not 2 but rear will become 3 because insertion according to the queue will be done only at the rear end. So in this way I have discussed what is the priority queue, how can it be represented using linked list or using one dimensional arrays and two dimensional array, and how to perform insert operation. Similarly, you can also perform the deletion operation. So obviously the deletion will be done from the front end of the queue. So in this way we can easily solve this problem. And I think these representations are very simple. I have explained this one with the proper diagram. I think you have got the logic. Thanks for watching this video.